I think that the Nobel Prize, and mostly the Nobel Foundation, wants and successfully can accomplish it, converting Nobel laureates into ambassadors of science. And that's important. Because politicians, it's very hard for them to understand what's going on in science. Because science is very long term. You know, achievements, you see in my case, you know, it took, we were short, it took like 20 years. But from time to time, it takes 30, 40 years to convert something into some, into an important achievement, and certainly to apply it. And politicians have the lifespan of their elections. So they live from election to election, and not only in Brazil, but in Israel, elections are not going by the law every 4 years, but every 2 years, because the government collapses, and then there is another election, and another election, and another election. So all what they look after the first election is to the second election. So they can measure their achievements by paving a road of 5 kilometers long. That's what they can do in one period. So they don't. So science is always hit, and the scientists also are very weak. They are not unionized. They are not working in the electric company. They cannot shut down the electricity in the country. They cannot shut airport. It's a weak. It's like old people, like retired people. They are. So therefore, science is hit very easily by. So therefore, I think that scientists do need ambassadors to talk to governments, to talk to politicians in their own countries, in other countries, and to convince them that science is the best investment you can do. Because you can take a poor country like Israel and convert it to a very rich country by using the brains of the people and converting it to a high-tech country, to people that make a lot of money, and therefore they live better life, they are more aware of their health, they are less dependent on the country to help them on welfare system.